animals don't need our compassion. They need us humans to understand that they are living beings and we are all passive on this earth. And we need to give them equal rights, just like we all demand our rights. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to bring to you that Sudan meant to just being a rhino. To me, it was a force. And we need to make sure that as we have come today here to celebrate a life for the East of Sudan, that we need to open our eyes. We can't circumvent around the truth that it is because of us that these animals are near extinction. We need, and that is Sudan's hope and prayer for us today, we need to understand that it is our calling to make the world a better place for these animals.
Today, we have come here to pay tribute to the people who managed to conserve the northern male white rhino. And Sudan today has left, but it's a symbol of education and understanding that we need to conserve so that we don't have an extinction of such species. At the same time, we want to appreciate we need to coexist between wildlife and humans. And humans, for that purpose, they need to feel the benefit. And we need to balance those two. I have appointed my PS and a team, both from the national government and the county government, and the private sector and the conservationists, to come up with a plan. How do we establish a museum or a center that we can be able to understand conservation better and educate the future of these people, of this country, that's the young generation.
Welcome to Magical Kenya.